Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the various advantages provided by set-top box. But before that, we are also going to have an introduction about the set-top box. So let's begin with the topic. Nowadays, the transmission of TV signal is in digital form. But most of the TV users still have analog TV, that means the signal which is received by the TV are in the analog in nature. Therefore, it is very much important to convert the transmitted digital signal into the analog form so that the user can view the television. So in order to provide that compatibility, it is very much important to have an analog to digital and digital to analog converter. And that requirement is get fulfilled by a set-top box. So basically, a set-top box is a hardware device which is used for the conversion of digital signal into analog form. At the same time, it performs the function of reception, demodulation, that is decoding of the signal, and conversion of the signal. The set-top box is also called as current converter, or it is also called as digital converter. The different types of set-top box are available in the market, and depending upon in which environment the set-top box is going to be used, based on that, the required set-top box is get selected. The advantage of set-top box is nothing but the number of channels which are present on the television systems are less as compared to the number of channels which are present on the set-top box. The set-top box are always connected between the TV receiver and the provider. The provider may be a satellite, it may be a cable operator, or it may be a terrestrial operator. So, in which environment or in which requirement the set-top box is going to be used, based on that the selection takes place. The different types of set-top box which are available in the market are nothing but the current converter set-top box, IPTV set-top box, then current source, or we can say the signal source set-top box, and many more. And these set-top boxes having a particular frequency range. So in that frequency range, the user requirement is get fulfilled. So let's move on to the advantages and disadvantages of set-top box. First, we are going through the advantages of set-top box. So definitely, the first advantage is nothing but related to the number of channels. The number of channels provided by set-top box are definitely more as compared to the number of channels provided by the television system. So here, the number of channels get increases to great extent. Now, the currently available channels are up to 100 to 200, but after digitization, it will get increased between 400 to 700. Next is nothing but the picture quality. As the signal is transmitted in the form of digital, therefore the accuracy of the transmission as well as the quality of the picture is get increased. More number of picture details, as more number of scanning lines are going to be used, therefore more picture detail or even a minute picture detail is get captured. And because of that, the picture quality is get increased due to the set-top box. So therefore, a huge improvement in the picture quality when using a set-top box. Then the next advantage is related to the interference of noise. Definitely, as the signals are transmitted in the form of digital signals, therefore there will be a less effect of noise as compared to analog signal, because the analog signals are get affected more with the noise as compared to digital signals, and therefore all sort of distortion will be get less in case of set-top box because it basically receives the digital signals. And then the next advantage is see what you want. Set-top box offers the packages according to the need of the channel and also pick up channels individually. So this is considered as one of the important features that the set-top box provide. Depending upon the requirement of the user, user can select any channel. There is no need to select the entire thing, and that will reduces the cost which is applicable to the user. Now moving on to the next advantage is cable operators will be able to offer HD quality, which is one of the most important use of set-top box and digitization. So because of digitization and because of the use of set-top box, it is possible to transmit the high definition video, which provides a very good picture quality as well as very good minute or even a minute picture details. So it is possible only because of the digitization of the signal and because of the use of set-top box. So this is also considered as one of the most important advantage of the set-top box. The next is nothing but a big switch on the television screen with the use of set-top box. It will bring on a digital revolution. So definitely, as the systems are getting digitized, the number of equipment or the number of circuits required in the television system get reduced. And at the same time, the picture quality and resolution will get increased. So that is nothing but the advantages provided by set-top box. Now, apart from these advantages, there are few disadvantages of the set-top box. Now, let's move on to the disadvantages part. Now, the first disadvantage is free-to-air channels will also not be available without set-top box. So definitely, as the signal transmission is in the form of digital signal, therefore, even the channel is free, the signal transmission is still in the form of digital signal. So in order to convert that digital signal into analog signal, it is necessary to have a converter. And that converter or that operation is get provided with the help of set-top box. So if you don't have a set-top box, then it is also not possible to convert the free air channel or to display the free air channels. So even a free air channels are get available after the use of set-top box only. Then the next disadvantage is, it will be mandatory to have a set-top box and this will put impact on the lower middle class people. So definitely the cost of the set-top box is also a factor when we want to select the channels and when we want to select the number of packages or number of channels the user want to view. So depending upon the user requirement, it is not possible for everyone to buy the high definition channel. So that will also consider as one of the disadvantage of the set-top box. So this is what about the various advantages and disadvantages of the set-top box. Apart from these advantages, the people prefer to have a set-top box as the number of channels get increased, picture quality is get better, and user can select any package or any channel depending upon its requirement. So because of this, the set-top box become more popular as compared to other systems. So I hope you understand the topic of advantages and disadvantages of the set-top box. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.